Equipment you will need to check out to square your stock: a small diameter piece of round stock, parallels, a long four-flute end mill, a large diameter end mill, a collet to hold the end mills, and a dead blow mallet. With a permanent marker, label your workpiece exactly as shown to ensure proper order is followed during machining. The side with the largest surface area should be machined first. Remove the burrs from the edges of your part with a file, and after cleaning the mating surfaces, place the large diameter end mill into the mill. Ensure the part and vise are clean and place the stock in the vise. Then use the round stock to force the stock to lie flat against the fixed vise jaw. Slowly touch the face of your piece with the end mill. Lock the quill in place and zero the Z-axis on the DRO. Apply cutting fluid and remove a few thousandths of material from your stock. When you face the piece in a clockwise manner, burrs on the edge of the part do not form since the mill cuts from outside the edge into the piece. Brush as many chips as possible before rotating the stock to position 2. Once again, clean the vise. File the recently cut edges and machine surface 2 with the round stock in the same manner as before. After facing the second surface, sides 1 and 2 should be square with each other. This can be checked with a machinist's square. Clean and place the parallels. Then rotate the piece so the two machine surfaces rest on the parallels in the back of the vise. Once again, place the round stock in front of the piece. Then strike the piece with a hammer to ensure it lays flat on the parallels before completely tightening it into place. Continue as before, machining the third and fourth sides. When clamping the fourth side, let end number 5 extend about a half inch beyond the vise jaws. This allows for side milling without repositioning. Since the three faces that touch the vise and parallels are square, the round stock isn't needed when machining side 4. Replace the large diameter end mill with the long end mill. Apply cutting fluid and touch off the end mill. Then move the end mill away from the part and adjust the X-axis to remove a few thousandths of material from the face. Continue cutting until the face is completely smooth. Flip the piece over and machine side 6. Once this is complete, all surfaces should now be square. Use a micrometer to verify parallelism.